What is going on, everybody? I am Mike. Welcome back to Tech 24/7 TV. I am glad that you're with me today because it is that magical day that we're all here for. It is iPad Pro release date. Got the 12.9 inch, 512 gig Wi-Fi only version in hand. I actually bought two of them, but we're going to talk about that in a minute here. Let's get started with the unboxing. New for 2021 is going to be the addition of mini LED backlighting in the 12.9 inch iPad Pro. I don't have the 11 inch at this moment. I do expect it later today, but if you want to see that, make sure you are subscribed and turn on notifications because that's going to be coming on later today, along with some additional videos around testing of the iPad Pro. Excuse the ASMR plastic. I've been a lover of the 12.9 inch iPad Pro as a laptop replacement. I do about 65 to 75% of my computing on this device, and I think that's only going to increase now with the addition of Thunderbolt support and this mini LED panel, which is supposed to be amazing. I really can't wait. Now, as I mentioned, this is the 500, wow, this feels heavy right off the bat. I could tell at least. This is the 512 gig Wi-Fi only version, and this is with 8 gigs of RAM. Now, I did buy another version for me to keep personally. I bought a 1 terabyte, 16 gigs of RAM, Wi-Fi and cellular version. That won't come here until the first week of June, unfortunately. And they're not even for sale yet. So I think they're just Apple's deprioritizing cellular models since they don't make that many of them. Before we get into the iPad, let's see what's in the box. We have some material, how to use the iPad. Like, we need instructions how to use the iPad, right? We're professionals here. And I believe there should be some Apple stickers in here. We have 2 white Apple stickers, kind of boring. I wish they were space gray because you're not pro unless you have space gray. We have a 20-watt USB-C charger and a 1-meter USB-C straight through cable. Now that that's out of the way, let's get to this bad boy. That is a beautiful sound. Beautiful sound. I am Team Space Gray. I've probably had a Space Gray iPad. Actually, just only the past two years. Previous to that, I had a silver one, which I like. It was nice to have, but I think space gray is kind of my color. Wow, it definitely does feel heavier. It's noticeable, at least in my opinion. Now, while this is powering on, a lot of people have commented about the usability of the iPad, really in terms of replacing your computer. Now, like I said in the beginning, I use this for about 65 to 75% of my computing tasks right now. And I think with the addition of Thunderbolt, only gonna increase. Let me know what you guys are thinking about this below. Are you gonna use this to replace your computer, or are you gonna use it for kind of an adjunct into something else, whether it's your MacBook Pro, your Mac Mini? Let me know down in the comments below. Now, while the iPad is finished setting up, I know a lot of people are gonna be interested in whether or not you can use it with the previous generation Magic Keyboard. I do have that here, and I still have the new second generation Magic Keyboard. What I would like to do is I'd like to restore from an iCloud backup, but since my iPad is running a non-release or a beta version of iPadOS 14.6, I cannot do that at this moment, so I'm gonna have to not transfer any apps, and we're gonna set up as brand new. Something about setting your device up as brand new gives it like a nice feeling. So this iPad shipped with 14.5, so these have been ready for quite some time. Now my iPad is right now just restoring photos. Wow, that looks different. Oh, because I have square turned on, that's why. So here on the left, we have the iPad Pro 2021. Here on the right is gonna be the iPad Pro 2020. You could see just by looking at them, without me telling you which one it is, there's very little difference between the two, if at all any. You really have to get up close and take a look at the height of one versus the other. Very minimal, the difference. It's 0.6 millimeters, which is very thin. From a weight perspective, this feels slightly heavier. I wouldn't say by much, but it does feel heavier. I could say that I don't often use this in tablet mode, just kind of holding it by itself. I do use it while I'm, you know, in a keyboard or in an iPad stand. That's probably the two most common ways that I use it. What I'm doing right now is I'm looking for an example of HDR content to play for you. Yeah, I guess from my perspective, this looks more vivid. You're seeing better blacks here. This looks dark. Not dark, like muddy. That's how I would explain it. It's definitely coming through on the monitor, so you should be able to see it in the video as well. Just to confirm, they're both at the same brightness, and I think you can see the difference here in her hand, here in the background. There's definitely a difference in terms of the color reproduction. Now, it's another good example of HDR content. For our second example of the color reproduction, we're gonna do Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse. Now, here again on the left is the new 2021. This is the 2020. and they're about maybe 4 or 5 frames apart. Now, from my perspective, anywhere that there's black on the 2020 iPad, as much as I thought it was completely black before, it's not until you see it side by side. Or that is absolutely positive. The dark parts here on the 2021 iPad Pro are actually pure black, where here they're like a bluish black, like a very light bluish black. I don't have a lux meter at this point. I ordered one, it's not here yet, because a lux meter is something that can measure the amount of light that is being produced from an object. So you can put that on the screen and you can measure the amount of light or the lux. I think just in kind of a side by side, very crude test, in my opinion, more brighter, more vivid. There is more color in this example here than there is on the 2020 iPad Pro. Now let's check a couple other things. I want to check data transfer speeds on Thunderbolt. That is actually what I'm really excited about. Now what I'm going to do is plug in my Samsung X5 Thunderbolt, and this is an NVMe SSD, which is capable of delivering somewhere between 22 and 2400 megabytes per second. So it's a really fast interface, and that's one of the things that Apple touted in the keynote about this, is that there's bidirectional bandwidth for 40 gigabits per second, which is a 4x increase over the 10 gigabit per second theoretical max of USB-C. Now, unfortunately, the way that the iPad works today, there is no progress meter inside a file. So if you want to, copy a file, it doesn't give you a progress meter. It gives you a very rudimentary visual of how far you're going or how far the progress is. Now, I've already taken a look at this here. I'm going to take this project file I have for my last a video for the Logitech Combo Touch for the 11-inch iPad Pro, the new one. Copy the entire folder. I'm going to go to On My iPad, and you see here I've got 482 gigs remaining. Right click, I'm going to click paste and start. Now again, on my M1 MacBook Pro, it took about 3 minutes when I transferred this file from the same drive to my M1 MacBook Pro. So I'm thinking it's going to take much longer, but we'll see. Again, this is a pretty crude test because there's no way to measure the read-write speed on an iPad at this point today. I'm hoping that Apple allows developers to bring this type of app to the iPad. We'll see what happens. Now, while we're waiting for this, if there's anything specific that you want me to test, please let me know down in the comments below. I'm really good at responding to comments. So if you have something that you want me to test, whether it's a use case with read-write, I have a ton of Thunderbolt accessories that I need to validate in my workflow. Let me know down in the comments below. Now, this just finished up. It was about 15 minutes and 20 seconds to do the math. If I had 313 gigs of data and I transferred that over to my iPad in 15 minutes and 20 seconds, the question is, what was that gig per second? That's what I want to figure out. I take the number of gigs, I want to convert that to megabytes just to make it easier for myself. And that's going to be 313,000 megabytes. And I convert the number of minutes into seconds, and that's going to be 920 seconds. So that math should be, it's about 340 megabytes per second. Still much, much less than the advertised Thunderbolt speed, but it is not bad. So if you were looking to buy the iPad Pro 2021 strictly based on the read-write transfer speed, I would say hold off, because WWDC is right around the corner. You don't want to buy a product today based on the promise or the potential of future software updates. That's just not how it works. That's at least not how it should work. A little bit disappointing. Again, I'm a little frustrated that Apple is not supporting the feature set out of the gate. Not that I ever expect them to support Thunderbolt 3 full, I guess the full feature set, but it is supported on the Mac. There are some work needs to be done in the terms of the operating system, but I guess that will remain to be seen what happens. Now, let me know if you have any questions about that down in the comments below. I have more testing from a hardware perspective. I have some other Thunderbolt docks, some displays I want to test, and I have some accessories I want to test out. If you want to see something specific, let me know down in the comments below. My name is Mike. This is Tech 24/7 TV. I'll talk to you guys in the next one.